Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learning Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1853. Use a slicer to choose the chart type. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Just got back from a week at Trainer Days in Switzerland. And this question came in while I was gone. This is from Edwin. Edwin says, some workbooks are designed with different charts or dashboards to show various metrics. And he talked about, instead of navigating to the next sheet, or scrolling up or down, wouldn't it be cool to have a filter or a slicer that changes the chart? So not just dynamic chart content, but dynamically changing from chart A to chart B to chart C to chart D. So something like this. The regular slicer is changing what's shown in the chart, but then we have a second slicer that completely changes the chart to something else. All right, so it took a little bit of time to set this up, and I'm going to walk through some of the tricks that I use to do this. All right, so there are, let's go back to the original data sheet. Here's the original data sheet. I created a pivot table from that, and in that pivot table, built the data for the first chart. Created a pivot chart from this pivot table. To this pivot table, I added the slicer that uses sector. So just insert slicer, and we have our sector slicers. That's normal, that's been covered in other videos. Okay, so now I have a pivot table with a chart and a slicer, copy that and paste it here. Lo and behold, I don't have to go to slicer connections. This pivot table is now also controlled by the first slicer. Got this one looking right and created a chart. Then got this one, again, copy this pivot table, paste here. The slicers are already connected and created a chart from this. Now I'm going to scroll down here to show you some of the tricks of how this actually works. Okay, over here in column AJ, this cell, AJ42, I named as start. So a named range there. And then the next three cells, I may be very tall and very wide. So each cell completely holds, is large enough to completely hold the pivot chart. And cut each pivot chart and paste it here. So here's AJ43, here's AJ44, here's AJ45. If you really had 10 charts, absolutely go for it. And keep doing this concept again and again and again until you have all 10 charts, one cell per chart, just lined up on top of each other. And again, the cell right above the first chart is called start up here in the name box. All right. Now this next part is a little bit tricky. I created a brand new data set, two columns. Column number one is called value. Those are just the numbers from one through how many charts you have, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And then a field called chart type, and that is what we want to appear in the slicer. So come up with nice names here, but keep them short so that way they will fit in the slicer. From this data set, these 8 cells, or if you had 10 charts, it'd be 22 cells, I guess, make a pivot table. I put the pivot table right here, and add a slicer to this pivot table that is slicing the value. The value is in the rows area. And then a slicer by chart type. That way, when I choose from the chart type slicer, the number that I'm going to get is the corresponding value, 1, 2, or 3. Some of you, I just heard it how you said, oh, I know where he's going with this. All right, this cell, the first cell in the pivot table, is called which chart. Which chart? So I have a name cell called start, a name cell called which chart. When we go to formulas, you will define a name. I've already defined the name, so we'll take a look at it. It's called show chart, and it is equal to the equal offset from the start. That's the cell above the first chart. How many cells down, which chart, and then 0 cells over. The 1 and the 1 are optional. I put them in just for good measure. All right, so we have a named range now called show chart. As I choose from the slicer, this value here is going to change, which will change which cell the which chart is going to point out. All right, then to make it all work, come here to the very first chart. I will Control C to copy that. Come back to underneath my slicers, and I'll put a second one here. And on the Home tab, we're going to say paste as linked picture. All right, so we now have a linked picture of that cell. And you'll see that when the link picture is selected, it is pointing to AJ43. I want to backspace through that. I have to use either a cell reference or a name range here. So it's equal show chart, press enter, and now the picture that I get corresponds to the show chart name, which is getting its data from the pivot table. So when I change to profit by region, that changes the number in this cell to a 3, because that's the value associated with profit by region. That forces the named range show chart to grab the third cell, to grab the third cell from the starting position, so 1, 2, 3, and then that gets fed to my camera tool. Very interesting way to have a slicer that actually changes the chart, and of course the other slicer, this is normal, we've seen this before, is changing which data is shown in the chart. Great idea from Edwin, required some tricky things there to make it work, but use it the next time you want a dashboard with just a single chart. All right, well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast, Mr. Excel.